The great white heron is a threatened species that used to number in the thousands in these coastal marshlands, but their numbers have plummeted in the recent decades due to human development encroaching on their habitat and reducing the size of their hunting grounds. The Ormond Beach wetlands is no exception. Nearby development has encroached into the wetlands over the past 30 years, introducing human activities that have also upset the sensitive and dwindling sand berms that protect the wetlands from saltwater intrusion. This particular location is a feeder channel for fresh reclaimed water maintained by the City Parks District. Perfect example what the adjacent wetlands could look like if they were properly maintained with enough fresh water, clean soil, and a variety of indigenous coastal trees and shrubs. Today we find the star of our show, hunting for gophers that burrow into the mud and the banks of the creek so to feed on insects. With her extremely acute sense of sight, hearing, and feeling, she can detect the slightest movements in the mud, and with pinpoint accuracy, she snaps them up in her long saber-like beak, swallowing them down in one gulp. Carefully stepping through the muck so as not to alert her prey, the great white heron of the Ormond Beach wetlands stalks her prey. It's been more than 5 minutes since we first encountered this wild and exotic creature, and in that time, she snapped up no less than 4 or 5 small rodents for lunch. It is quite plain to see that the great white heron is the queen of the creek. Of all the various habitats that comprise the Ormond Beach wetlands, it's ironic that the most beautiful and life-sustaining part of the ecosystem is that in which a number of municipal agencies are working together to maintain this freshwater channel that runs through the nearby city park, showing us how the entire wetlands could look, provided these agencies could expand this care to include the actual estuary just beyond the nearby condominiums project. By working together, these agencies, with help from the California Department of Conservation and the Coastal Commission, could create a thriving wetlands that would be the envy of any community in coastal California.